Afternoon to all of you. I was asked to give a theme paper. I do not know what that stands for now, the relevance, because I guess half of the session or maybe three-fourths of the session is already over before I came.
One-fourth. But we have 10 minutes to do the three-fourths.
Okay. So just in those 10 minutes, I thought I'll just talk about a few things. How I'm going to basically not give the presentation or talk to you is that there are a few problems that I'm going to focus on. How the legislation or the judiciary is dealing with those problems, and what we think can be the solutions by the copyright owners. So just very few areas which may be of interest, that is what I'm going to basically talk about. The first thing is, I got some examples for you, right? Did you talk about these examples?
No, but do you want to plug the...
Where is it working?
Yeah.
Is it there?
Yeah. The plug's right here.
Okay.
Therefore...
Okay.
That's the engineer in me, folks. And then maybe someone from the organization. There you go.
Why did you switch it off for me? That's not the engineer like quality.
Women involved.
Yeah. Should we vote now?
That's more important. Leave it.
Yeah.
That's more important. So I thought I'll just first get a few examples for you that might be of some interest. Yes. We have all heard about Guzarish film done by, I think, Leela Bhansali, who's supposed to be one of the most reputed directors. And there was allegations against him that he's picked up novel Goonjuti Chennai. The last two also, Ranjan story picked up by Bombay Talkies. Bombay Talkies is having 3-4 stories. So one of the authors, Ranjan, says that my story has been picked up. Atithi Tum Kab Jaoge went into a lot of problem. They filed a case with dispute settlement authority. Then they went to a higher authority. The person was asked to pay some 10 lakhs of rupees. He didn't pay the money to the script writer. And thereafter what happened, probably they are going to the court. I'm not sure what has happened in that case. Now, this is what the Indian scenario is. But that is the same thing in Hollywood also. That's the second example that I've given. Soul Shattering, taken up by Angela Jolie's In the Land of Blood and Honey. Now, if script writers, they write scripts, and they're taken up by the movie makers, how do we deal with it? You know, there is a problem. Just now I was talking to, suddenly the name is not
coming.
Dinesh. He was talking about the problems about the print media. See, this is exactly what you've got, the print media, and when you move to the from print to the entertainment media, and especially the movie media that you talk about, visual and the audio media, what happens is you can bring a lot of changes and show that you've not taken it from the novel or from the script. So how to handle this kind of a situation? The matter doesn't end there. We have a lot of people going to, you know, these... cable operators that you see or the channels. In the morning I heard Balaji was here, and what you find out is that there is a serial which is running into hundreds and hundreds of episodes. In India we have serials running into unending episodes, and we don't even know when the story is going to come to an end. And how this really works is you give a concept note to the broadcasting organization, and when you give a concept note, you're not writing the entire story, you're simply giving a concept. And when you give a concept, there's some kind of a confidentiality between the two, or at least fiduciary relationship saying that this will not be passed on to anyone. One. Secondly, that if the people, the TV people, make use of that concept note, what they're going to do is that they're going to acknowledge the person who's given it to them. And due acknowledgement is both ways. It's one acknowledgement in print, and the second acknowledgement is that you pay money. Now, nowadays, IPR is not simply about, you know, intellect. It's more about investment and less about intellect, I believe. So what happens in this kind of a case? Concept is, you know, when we talk about the copyright law, we all know that originality is the basic idea that one is talking about. But when we come to concept notes, what the High Court of Delhi has done is, it has come up with a novelty idea, and they said if a concept is novel, then what will happen? There is a copyright which vests in your concept. So what is happening is, there is the basic thing saying that there is no copyright in an idea, But if the idea is a novel idea and it is converted into a concept, then copyright vests in that particular idea. This is what the situation now is. Now, what happened in these cases, we have heard about the two big swimmers. Our foreign friends wouldn't know what swimmer means. It basically means choosing a bridegroom for yourself, right? You yourself choose the bridegroom. Normally, what happens in India is you have parents doing it for you. Now, in the two swimmers, Sita and Draupadi, and all of us, we know, what happened was that it was not Draupadi or Sita who were choosing the swimmer. It was the fathers who had said that these are the criteria. If these criteria would be fulfilled, then Sita is going to get married to that particular person, and that's how she got married to Ram. Same thing for Krishan Kanaiya, some concept note was made. Now, what happened in the first case was, I will not go into all the cases, but just to show what it means is, what happened in the first case was that a new idea in the sense that Swayamvar is the girl herself choosing the bridegroom was given to the channel. And when the entire concept was made, it was like, you know, a reality show had to be shown that a girl is sitting and she's interviewing various boys and she chooses the best person for herself. Now, this novel concept was given to the TV channel, and what the author found out later on was that this idea was used by the channel and they started making a serial on it, the reality show on it. But the due acknowledgement was not given to, this is that famous Anil Gupta versus Das Gupta case. Thereafter, there have been a number of cases, and the latest being Urmi Jovarkar. She talked about, how certain groups of people, they go to various localities and how they work and what is their efforts bypassing the bureaucracy, and that should be shown on TV. And what was done by CNN and IBN was that they picked this up, converted the families into individuals, and they started showing the episodes. Now, this also, Urmi Jovarkar fortunately won the case. Now, again, what had been held here is that originality is not there in the sense that you're talking about a new idea, a novel idea. If there is a novel idea, you put it into print, there is a copyright which is vesting into it. I have a few questions here, why are you giving that glare to me?
Oh, it's not a glare, it's a loving, affectionate look.
Okay. I thought he was telling me that enough, keep quiet now. So I'll take at
Man,
least five...
Man, my wife must have problems interpreting my look.
Five more minutes.
No, but ma'am, so, what I wanted to say is, in the patent context, coming from where I come from as an engineer and having done IP, the novelty could be defeated, right? So I don't know, in your Krishan Kanaiya example, you said in the second one how...
The first one also and the third
they
one
They won
also.
As well in the Swayamvar where the woman herself chooses.
Yes.
So what would have happened, and I'm just going to, for the benefit of the students out there who are taking IP, I heard you guys talk in the hallway, you know, when an IP is asserted against somebody, the first defense that the other person takes is not only that I not do it, so non-infringement.
Yes.
But also that it's invalid, meaning it wasn't granted properly in the first place. And then finally, it's unenforceable, which is inequitable conduct. In the case of this, that I would have attacked, from a patent point of view, the novelty itself of the woman choosing, because the two examples you gave can be differentiated, which is Sita and Draupadi. However, the way patents work, if you follow the way litigation works, just by way of teaching or enlightenment, is then you find prior art that was not in front of the patent office. You try to find another example. They may have looked at the Sita Draupadi example and said, oh, wow, this is distinguishing because here the lady chooses rather than the bow or stringing the bow. When, in fact, something goes to litigation, they go and look for more prior art. And if you look at the Nal and Damayanti story, in which Damayanti herself at her Swayamvara chooses, that would have been a prior art that hadn't been discovered by the patent office. You bring that prior art in front of the people at the time and say, look, now what's novel about this? And then they would lose on novelty, which means they wouldn't have a copyright on novelty or a patent on novelty, and therefore they couldn't assert it, and it would have been finished at that
point.
Can
I just give an answer to
that? Please.
That's exactly what I'm trying to say, that as far as copyright law is concerned, originality is the test. And when you say originality is the test, it simply means form of expression given by the person, right? So the idea may be there. Like, for example, if you look at all of our Bollywood films, they're all based upon that ishq or love that you call, right? So from beginning till the end, love angle has to be there, otherwise it would not be there. So we cannot have a copyright on love. right? Similarly, if you are saying choosing of a bride or a bridegroom, either by way of a swayamvar or by way of whether it is Damayanti or it is Sita or anyone for that matter, there's nothing great about it. These things happen. So why is it? Who gave an authority to the judges to have the concept of novelty in the copyright law? Novelty talks about prior art, which is a part of patents. And patents cannot be clubbed with copyright. So that is what exactly I'm trying to say, that we are developing a law in India which is saying that if there is a novel concept, if it is put into print, then it is copyrightable. I'm basically challenging that itself. That cannot happen. But anyhow, these things are happening because this is the way judiciary is giving judgments. And what they do is, see what happens, you're talking about, you deal with trade secrets. When we are saying that this is, you know, a kind of an agreement between the two people, the author and the channel, what happens is that at that point of time, there is confidentiality. But the moment it is shown on TV, the confidentiality goes away. So when the confidentiality is going away, it's no more a novel concept, it gets into public domain, what happens? Would you continue with the copyright on that? Or would you put a full stop? The answers have not been given by the court, and we are going on and on with this. So that is one area I think people have to think about. Anybody who wants to make a comment, you're most welcome. I don't want to continue with my, you know, yes.
Yeah.
Hello.
Hello, ma'am. I would I just recall when you're talking about this Swayamvarga concept and the others, there was this movie called Buffy, and it believed like there were shots from Chaplin movie were taken like frame to frame.
Well, you know, there have been a number of situations. For example, I don't know whether you remember or not, there's something called The Weakest Link.
Yeah, yeah.
That's one of the English serials. We had Kamzor Kadi Kaun.
Yeah.
We have this Kaun Banega Karodpati.
Yeah.
Now, the thing is, can we take those, it depends upon the kind of rights which are given. As far as the rights to the producers of the films are concerned, the right given is the right to make copy of the work, right? And if you look at the author of the literary and musical work, the right given is right to reproduce the work. Now that means, evidently, when you're using two different words for two different kinds of authors, there has to be a distinction between reproduction and making of a copy.
Yeah.
Right? All right. Yes, carry on. There is a difference between inspiration,
yes,
copy, imitation. So when we talk about copyright infringement, we neither talk about inspiration, nor do we talk about imitation, nor do we talk about, taking verbatim or taking shot by shot. What we talk about is copyright infringement. So since copyright is a statutory right, one has to go to the statute to find out whether it fits into there or not. One, to begin with, I personally feel copyright law is basically for the artists and the authors to bloom. It's basically meant for pure artists, pure artwork, pure literary work. But what we are doing today is we are bringing a lot of investment into this. And a lot of technologies are coming up which are, where you can see, for Angur, for example, how many of us we know Shakespeare in work? And Shakespeare there in UK, all gone for so many years now. Even the Shakespearean Trust there would not be interested in picking up on any of the Indian who's done this kind of a work, right? So basically, there is in Hindi a saying, Chor Kaun Jo Pakda Gaya. So how these things are happening is, maybe that there are no agreements, nothing between them, but what happens is you do something, nobody wants to file a case against you. But yes, legally speaking, there are still not many cases on this, so we do not know how the courts are going to read about it. But if you just pick up plot by plot in a story, there is definitely a violation of copyright. And what the 2012 amendment has done is, it has changed the definition of the cinematograph film, and it has also brought a change to the rights of the producer of the cinematograph film by adding the word performance there. So when you add the word performance, probably along with copy, performance would come. So we may be in a situation to, have even these cases under infringement. So, yes.
Thank Ma'am, translating any author's work in some vernacular language or something, so does that infringe the author's copyright?
No, it is the author of the copyright has the right of translation. So what you can do is you can take the consent of the author and translate. But then there are certain provisions in the Act itself where suppose if it's a fictional work or it's a scientific work or it's, you know, they've given various kinds of years, like term 7 years for something, 3 years for something, 1 year for something. After that period lapses, you can make a translation. But what happens in those cases is even when you make a translation, what you do, a part of your profit has to go to the original author. Because after all, it is the original author who's done the work and what you're doing is simply translating. Yes, anything else? Yes.
Madam, there's a lot of buzz about Creative Commons. So can you just enlighten us about Creative Commons?
Can you enlighten
commons?
Me on this, what it means, Creative Commons?
Madam, no one owns the copyright. Someone produces something and he's willing to share it with everyone. And in Creative Commons also, I think there are various sections in which there's one section in any person can use it. Then there's one section in which a producer can use it, but he has to pay the copyright. But any person, a normal person can use it. So I think Creative Commons is applicable for music, for electronic media.
See, Creative Commons, as I understand, is once anything gets into public domain, the person who creates something has a proprietary right on the work. And once you have the proprietary right, you can relinquish your rights. Once you relinquish your rights, what will happen is that anyone can make use of it, right? So therefore, what is the question?
So, madam, is it in the open domain? Can he claim?
The moment we say something is in public domain means anyone can make use of it.
So, can the producer claim any right over
producer
that
of what?
That particular item might be a clip, might be a sound.
No,
clip.
Once he says it gets into public domain, I relinquish my rights. Then he cannot do anything.
So,
with
madam, my question was, most of these things, like she said, there's a book. Does the book also come into the Creative Commons arena after
No. Okay, now I understand what you're saying. See, public domain, as far as patents is concerned,